this video, we're going to talk about one very important thing. Which one is more important to you, game design or graphics? Are you all about that sweet gameplay, or are you really about the eye candy that you can get displayed through your 4K, 1080p, or 1440p monitor? Let's talk about it. What up, everybody? It's your boy Gaming Forte, back at it with another video. And honestly, I believe this discussion is really going to come down to when you were born. Now, there are going to be people that are going to be late bloomers that jumped onto the bandwagon a little bit later and are probably going to say that game design is the best thing for a gamer. But you also have a lot of millennials out there that was born within the last 10 to 15 years that are going to say that graphics are king, and this is the one thing that they base their buying decision off when it comes to playing their game. But in order to have this conversation with you guys, I'm just going to give you my opinion and my opinion only. So when you talk about game design, you talk about the way the game feels, the way it plays, the way it reacts to the slight movements you make on the thumbstick as you push the button, or the way that you pull the trigger when you want to fire that bullet down range, and the way that you actually just bring all that together to bring a very coherent style of play that is very satisfying and addicting as a gamer. Gameplay and game design is the things that make people stay up at night when it comes to playing their games on different systems. It also keeps PC gamers up late at night trying to get the optimal settings for their game of choice that they like to play. Many people go through hours and hours and hours of time of just setting up their keyboard and mouse, or setting the sensitivity of the dead zones on their remote control to give them the best precise gameplay experience that they can get. Most gamers will even go as far as to turning down gameplay graphic settings to actually get more performance out of the games that they are playing. This is nothing new to a PC gamer, because that is something that has always been inherited to actually being that type of gamer. But when it comes to console gaming, you really don't have that type of option. But still, all above all, gameplay is still king. There's a reason that Call of Duty is one of the most selling games of this generation, and even the previous generation, Call of Duty hit its highest peak during the Xbox 360 and PS3 generation. The reason I bring this to everybody's attention is because games like Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3, Black Ops 1, Black Ops 2, the reason those games did so well is because the gameplay loop was serious, fun, and it was very addicting. Modern Warfare was the first Call of Duty that I put more than 75 to almost 100 hours, or 100 days, I should say, in gameplay in. I loved the gameplay loop that that game had in it. And then you have games on the other side of the spectrum like Destiny that are more modern games that look really good and have really good gameplay loops. The thing about these games are they're more addicting just because of the gameplay that they bring to the table. Bungie used to always have this saying, 30 seconds of fun, when they made Halo games. And that was the reason people like to play it. How often are you getting into those 30 second skirmishes where you feel like, man, I can't believe I got through that part, or man, this was intense, or man, this was an awesome experience to do with your friends and play against other people? That is the type of thing that makes gamers want to come back and play your games more. Now, let's talk about the graphical side of it. Now, graphics are very, very important. I believe graphics are mostly used during the showing off phase of the game, during the marketing period of the game. You really can't show off gameplay experiences when it comes to marketing your game to patrons that want to actually enjoy it, but you can definitely do that when it comes to the graphical settings. I honestly believe that's the main reason 4K is such a big moniker right now during this generation, because you really can't show off 60 frames per second. You can put that in a press release and say that, hey, our game's going to run at 4K native 30 frames per second during this mode, but we're also going to have this performance mode that's going to drop the performance of the resolution down to like 1080p, but you're going to get a max and a solid 60 frames per second. I can definitely see that being something they throw in a press release, but when it comes to showing it off to the masses, they're going to put that big 4K logo up on it, and they're going to say, this is what this game looks like when they demonstrate it. Because that's what most people talk about this generation. They talk about the graphics, how the game looks, and not until Digital Foundry started bringing out the performance of games and really talking about that on a sub-mix level for people to even appreciate the graphical and gameplay developments that you can actually get from performance when you play your game. But it still doesn't change the fact that some people, and even a lot of people, believe graphics are way more important than gameplay. Well, being a person that has a very, very nice PC that I just built, I will definitely tell you that I really do like graphics, but I will pillage my graphics in order to have a better running game. And if it really came down to me playing on a platform that was suboptimal to what I wanted to play, I would actually go out and spend the money to upgrade to what I really, really want. That's the reason I went out and bought an Xbox One X, because like I said earlier, or not in this video, but in past videos, the reason I have an Xbox One X is because I want the most powerful system to play with my friends on a console that they prefer to play on. I really do prefer playing on the Xbox, but if I can get people to switch over and play on PC, the world would be such a better place for me. I enjoy playing on my Xbox. I really do. But if I can play those same games on my PC with a higher frame rate, higher graphical fidelity, and get the best of both worlds, what gamer wouldn't want that? That is what gaming is. Gaming is all about options, and you wanted to play the way you want to play. That's the reason that Microsoft put all these games on the PC platform, because they don't want to tell you what to do with the games that you like to play. So in my humble opinion, I will always pick gameplay and design over graphics any day of the week. I believe we are in a unique situation where we can actually define the way we want to play games for ourselves. And it's not up to another person to make that decision for us. It's up to you as a gamer to decide that I want to have more from my games. I don't want to play the same experiences that everybody else is playing. But I do understand that that sometimes can be very unrealistic, because even knowing you do want to play on a better platform, maybe the PC is better for you, but you have to acquiesce because you like playing with the friends that you like to play with. And I can understand why some people only have PlayStation 4s and PCs, because you kind of get the best of both worlds when it comes to third-party games, and you still get the Microsoft games, so you're not missing out there, but you don't get those PlayStation exclusives. And those PlayStation exclusives are very, very precious to a lot of people. There was only one reason, and one reason only, for me owning a PS4, and that was to play God of War. I do love the Uncharted series, and I do love Last of Us, and I will play those games when they come out, but God of War was the pinnacle for me. I didn't know that God of War was coming out, so I did buy that PS4 on a whim and a hope to think that that game was releasing. And when they finally did announce that it was coming, I was all in. I had the system to be able to play it on. And trust me, during my 36 to 40 hours of playing it, I enjoyed every bit of it. And that game graphically was stunning. Would I love to play that game at 60 frames per second on PC? Yes, I would. But am I going to go nut back crazy because I'm not able to? No, I'm not. I'm just going to play the games where they are and play them and enjoy them for what they are. But I will always choose the gameplay experience over the graphical fidelity of a game. And that will never change for me. And hopefully a lot of you guys can understand where I'm coming from on that. And a lot of you guys can literally sit back and think about it. You know, when you buy your next system, is your next system, you're buying it just because you are a fan of that platform, or are you buying it just because it's the right system for you? Hopefully you're buying it because it's the right system for you. Friends trump all in that regard, but don't just buy it because you're just a fan of that platform. You can always go out and spend the money to actually get that platform later, but you can't always make a good decision the first time around, because sometimes you just don't have the money to go back and actually change that decision at a later date. And that's what I really wanted to touch bases with you guys. This is like one of those more heart-to-heart videos that I've been thinking about making and talking about why I made the decisions that I made in my gaming career over the last few years, and how I've just been slightly pushing further and further away from just being a person that just prefers Xbox to a person that just doesn't really care where he plays his games at this point. If I can just get my friends to come over with me, man, that would be a wrap, and I would have no reason to stay where I am. And I hope you guys understand that. But that doesn't change the fact that I will still be on Xbox. I will probably still always own an Xbox unless something changes. And you can always find me on Xbox Live. You guys see the gamer tag. It's always popping up on the screen when I'm playing these games. Plus, it's linked in the description and everywhere else that you can follow me at. So guys, like I always say, thanks for watching this video. Sub to the channel if you haven't. Like this video if you like the content. It definitely helps out the channel a lot. Turn on those notifications. It's gonna let you know the next time one of my videos go live. It's your boy Gaming Forte. You guys have a great week, and I'm gonna talk to you in my next video. Peace.